Welcome back to AS E DEY HOT. We just take that one to cool down the temperature so that Oga Duke go just swallow spit, because if he go answer this question, the thing dey very, very long as per se a complex question. Oga Duke, over to you.
I don't know about complex, but the thing be say, you know, as you don't point out, nothing looks like it dey change at all at all. We defy the fight for yesterday corruption, but today corruption is going on as normal. Everywhere you go, where people they collect money last year, if you go today, they can still collect money. So if you go passport office now, one collect passport, they'll collect money. If you go police station, one commot, they'll collect money. So altogether, nothing much is happening. And even 2 days ago, I hear say these new ministers, they're just coming up great. I hear say they don't give them two salaries to give to anybody they like. We no concern the work we're going to do, and that's official. And if it is untrue, let the federal government come out and say it's not true. So you tell me how corruption will stop when the basic things that actually encourage corruption still there inside our society. Because all the ones who they do the corruption at the top, at the very level, are doing it because they have learned to do it at a small level first. And as they proceed and progress, they get better and better and bigger. So it is difficult to stop them. That is the way they are used. I know many civil servants who never earn $1 million in their entire career, but the property where they get for this Lagos and Abuja past $10 million. And they're civil servants. So the key thing we say, corruption in this country will only go when the government begins to look at the grassroots of corruption, not just picking the big boys at the top and putting them away, because it's never going to stop anything at all, at all. And for me, therefore, I would say the fight never begin, but we have put down a marker where we want to start. And this particular work they do now, this 1.2.1 billion, is the beginning of that marker. Once we can get this out of the way and secure convictions, so actually get people, make them say, see quite clearly, say they're guilty, I think that is the first step to going to fight corruption everywhere else in our society. But at this point in time, I don't think the will is that strong.
Oga Duke, this your answer. The thing they ginger hope for people mind, because the way you take talk and you talk and I say, okay, oh, make we give government chance. But he get one thing when we go to the call trust deficit, when on there between the people and those when they for power, because of say the people when they for power don't promise to do this, they no do. They don't say they go do that, they no do. But this government come riding on the mantra of change, promising say the kind way when they will take fight corruption. Now something when we say we never see for this country before. But fighting corruption no be just mouth. We need to get certain things in place. If now military regime when we know say okay, oh, the constitution they don't suspend them now through decrees and edicts and the government they rule. They will catch anybody at any time, put them for inside prison. But we get system now when we say you need to carry person go court. But we can't look our court. It be like say some people get lawyer when we say they sabi the constitution in and out. They don't know where it be. Say okay, oh, if the thing don't hook us here, we go go here. Now why we go to hear things like interlocutory injunction? We go to hear say this particular court don't get a jurisdiction over the matter. Some go run from federal high court, they will go state high court, they will go supreme court, they will come down to the court. Cases go come to drag for 7 years, 10 years. And now why Nigerians they look say this one? If after 6 months or 1 year we no hear anything about this one, we go just fold our arms, come out time. Make we can't look the judiciary when get road to play for here. Political will now wanting on the side. This government talks to them get the political will. The judiciary, they're supposed to get their own ginger too. To you see, say, okay, oh, if we pursue these people, we'll go pursue this case until it reach the end. But make we check our judges and our lawyers them. How you take things, say, we'll go get situation when we say, person no go, they look, say, make I go defend person when we say, maybe, we know, say, you get the right, maybe I can defend you. But when you come, they defend, not with the intent of showing, say, the person, they innocent. But to just they waste time, they I go speak English, I don't know. Dilly dally.
Must you tell me say you go speak English? Well, don't they speak
and sing, so the thing we say with a lawyer, the lawyer, when you get client for your front, where you defend, you go defend them to the best of your ability. Even if you believe they're not completely innocent of the crime, you still have an obligation to do your best to try and persuade the law that your client no get a question to answer. But the judiciary is corrupt, as you say. The executive was corrupt. Let's not say is corrupt. Let's say the executive was corrupt. We don't know that this one is corrupt yet. But the legislature is even more corrupt. And that is a major problem. Because no matter the thing where the president won't do, if you know fit carry the legislature with it, you know go fit succeed.
Yes.
Yeah, they go fit put block. They even fit impeach himself if they want to. So ultimately, the president is now like a man who is trying to drive a compromise and balance things out. Because if you look into the legislature itself, legislature is full of people who have been in government in this country for a long time. And by anybody in this country will tell you, you find it very hard place to find any person for this country. We will tell you, say, person, we don't become governor for this country before for 4 years, no corrupt. It's impossible. I don't believe it, personally. I will find it very difficult to believe that any governor that has run this country, any this state, is in this country, is corruption free. Because if you're corruption free, then Nigeria won't be the way it is. So when I see people who have been in power come back again, they've gone from the state government house and they ended up in the House of Senate. Wetin be the reason for that? Why you go one go Senate after you don't become governor? Mm. Only one reason. So you could go protect the wrong way you don't do before.
Mm.
Yeah, and that is my own feeling. So for this government, I think maybe from next time where they come look for a vote, they should try to deselect some of the people where they run. Because at the moment, they needed those people in order to come into power. Okay. That was the problem.
Mm-hmm.
Without those people, they couldn't get rid of Jonathan.
Hmm.
So they had to collude even with the devil in order to get rid of Jonathan.
Hmm.
And most of these people, remember, even cross carpets from PDP come enter APC. Mm-hmm. So if you're indicting PDP politicians and say all of them are corrupt, then some of these APC will also be corrupt because some of them are ex-PDP
politicians.
Or product PDP. So ultimately, the biggest problem for the president, not be himself, but now the people where they work with.
Hmm.
So those guys, as you say, who are in the judiciary, those guys who are in the Senate, are they willing to sing from the same hymn book as the president? I don't think they are. I think their own interest is more important than the interest of Nigeria, and this is one thing that the president has to fight against. If he can fight and beat those people, he will be on his way to solving Nigeria's corruption problem.
Quick one. We get this call from Oga Bobby. Oga Bobby, they call us all the way from Amsterdam. Oga Bobby, good morning, sir.
Agree to now.
Oga Bobby, good morning.
The thing is, I want you to contribute more to the topic. You say the solution to corruption for Nigeria, I think we need to cut the salary of the Senate and governors to the same salary when we say teachers, they receive, civil servants, they receive for say that country, then we go know those who go run, who go won contest for any position in the country. We know say yes, if they come with the full mind of, you know, say yes, the salary, because now the salary be the attraction to the government, because I see say the people when they're there, they'll not be people when get the interest of the country. Rather, the interest of yourself. You understand me now? Because if you make a civil servant salary the same thing with governor and president, everybody's salary the same thing, then you go see, say, yes, people won't come to contest. They're not going to be people when they say, we were in position now. Because the attraction of, because you go talk about a wardrobe allowance. Different allowance of different things, and the allowance when they cost, so he passed the salary of a civil servant there. You understand me now? So those are the things that when we say even only that one they lose, it's more than any other thing. So now the best thing is to cut the salary of every governor and senate to the same salary. Move see who go wrong, who go contest.
Yeah.
You understand me? So those are the problem. We have to cut the salary of these things them out.
Thank you very much for that contribution all the way from Amsterdam. Oga Duke, how you go take react to this contribution when he don't make? He talk say, may they slash the salary the level when we say civil servant. So that they're going to say, okay, even though now leadership, neither they provide for us, they also be our own servants.
But now add to it, Chukwu, just cause slashing of salary. Now one thing, but you make also bear in mind, say, some of them be head of committee for one particular this thing. Some of them get contracts, whether they do it, whether they are approved. And then all these things, somehow, corruption, they also play out there. Not be the salary.
Okay, so, you're absolutely right. The salary is important, but it's not just salary, it's the overall remuneration, everything that they're getting from being in that office. Whether it's allowances, salaries, whatever, it's far too much, and it's an incentive for people to come in there and fight to the death in order to get it. So you are right in that. And what I would like to see is not just a cut in salary, but also the removal, they make you remove allowance completely. Instead, we pay expenses. There's a difference in allowance and expense. So in other words, I can give you an allowance of 50,000 naira for clothes, for every month. Now, you may spend only 10,000. Mm-hmm. The rest of it go in your pocket. However, I can say to you, every time you buy new clothes for work, bring in the receipt, we'll pay for it. Yeah, which is what happens in civilized environment. Mm-hmm. You get your expenses paid for. Mm-hmm. And that expense could be public knowledge. So every senator, there'll be a website for the Senate where you can go and see the expenses of every senator this year, mm-hmm. what he spent. So if you fly to your constituency four times in a month, you claim the air ticket. Mm-hmm. If you stay in a hotel or you have a second residence in your constituency where you spend, we give you an allowance for that, for specifically for that accommodation. You're paying 3 million naira a year for that, we give you 3 million naira, full stop, straight to your landlord or straight to you, either way. But most importantly, make we stop expenditure at elections. I don't know if it is actually illegal to spend money, for, no, a certain amount of money in election. There's no limit to what you can spend. No, but it's illegal. It's a limit. What you can spend. Yeah. And also, you are not allowed to dash money on election mm-hmm. day or mm-hmm. at any point in time. Mm-hmm. These are the things that zero tolerance should bring for us. There should be a law, if there isn't one already that is specific, that says that elections should be an expenditure-free environment. If any politician hands a penny to anybody, he gets disqualified automatically. So the money should not change hands during election at all. And once you do that, like I'll put it on to you, you don't go see any thug carrying gun come shooting. Because the reason why thug they come, because they give them money. If you don't give money, you go somewhere, they look for money, where you go chop.
Exactly.
Because you don't come there to fight for you if there's nothing in his pocket to chop.
Exactly.
So once we stop that disbursement of money, remove money from politics, mm-hmm. and at the end of the day, let politicians tell people what they want to do for them and let them vote on their words, mm-hmm. not on bag of rice or, as some of them put it, stomach infrastructure. Mm-hmm. That has to go. So reduction in remuneration for legislators, removal of expenditure for elections, and a strict adherence to the upper limit of what any party can spend, and then a clear requirement for all parties to say where the money come from.
Okay, Oga Duke, you've done talk something with the very important. So okay, and the issue that is say okay, the particular amount of money we a particular political party supposed spend, maybe particular amount of money we they supposed assign to any governance. Okay, fine. These things we talk about now. Some of them, a lot of these things, they constitution. You understand? Okay. And yet, the same leaders we suppose they abide by this constitution are the same people where they defy the same constitution. Okay, what did at this point in time we can't hold them responsible, say you don't break the law. Okay, a typical example, we say INEC will be say will be what then describe as independent
National
Commission. The word independent in quote, you understand? Suppose they're independent and then they get their own law, say okay, anybody who violates electoral law, they will do it. They go either punish them or commot them from the contest. Okay, a typical example, 1 billion naira. Now it's supposed to be their particular amount of money where they're supposed to spend for presidency. But in the case of them, they see money running so hundreds of billions and all that. Where the constitution know they strong and where the people are supposed to carry out the constitution know they play their own role. Where think this could be the alternative? Because just like say, we serve, just like say everybody just they we know they as if this, the same people will say they protect us. Mm-hmm. You have like nobody they make move to ensure that they protect us because the same people are supposed they put that law on ground. That's the same people they violate
that. Okay, this is why Nigerians should be happy that we get one president who don't enter politics or enter that position on a promise. The promise being, say, I go fight corruption to a standstill.
Exactly.
He said that to us. So let's put him to task. Let's say to Oga Buhari, you promised us this, deliver it.
Mm-hmm.
Show us you're fighting corruption by bringing in everybody else in line with you. Because we don't know, politicians waiting for a legislature, mm-hmm. no go want to comply with this. They'll be the ones where they spend the money, as mm-hmm. you say, and nobody fit around them. But first of all, if Buhari, as the Oga Patapata, now in the appoint EFCC chairman,
mm-hmm.
if he call EFCC chairman and say, look, my friend, this is what I want you to do. I want you to specifically start following expenditure by politicians. Specifically. And anybody who spent the money past, I want that person brought the book. And that is a specific mandate, not a general fight corruption, but do one thing for me. And then make an announcement to the whole nation. Let him come out. Even if it doesn't work, let him come out and announce to the whole nation, from today, politicians are no longer allowed to spend this amount of money. And you say it in Senate. If anybody in this Senate has an objection, raise your hand now so Nigerians can see you. Can see you and say you don't want progress. So at the end of the day, when the EFCC man then begin to arraign them, There'll be no complaint. Hmm. And if he has the mandate of the president and he knows the president is right behind him, hmm. he will do it.
But we'll also see some senators who will get the liver to come and talk, say,
Ogadu.
Say the particular amount of money, say the money they approve to them, say they deserve them and all that.
No,
something like shame, not even there.
But the question is, let's have a discourse. Like me personally, I'm prepared to sit with any senator of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and discuss the remuneration. Hmm. Let him convince Nigerians that he deserves it, and let me convince Nigerians that he doesn't. Let's see what Nigerians will buy.
Hmm. Oga Duke, this thing where you just talk now, you just be like, say, you get waiting for secondary school.
Hmm.
People will sabi how to copy where we are. I know say Nkubi.
Please. This is the second time they come on this program. They accuse me of something. The first one, he talks, say, you give, if I give my wife money, you can't do anything. You don't do it.
He's mind himself.
Mind yourself, because
Our
people when go secondary school before after independence, you know, go even fit the example because you go school before independence.
I say an old man.
No, I'm not. If you see the cap, you go notice. Would they come discuss as they dress like would they go village meeting? Now land, you say we won't come share for here, but that's another
side.
If they shall land, not give my
own. He is picking on me. And that's why they normally pick on me. When Nigerians there are aware of say they pick on me.
Tell him.
You be beans?
You tell say him, I'm picking him. On you. Now you go and go there as well that you be beans. How can
either
I be picking
way,
on you?
Look. Chukwudi.
Okay, Ogadu, may I ask my question?
For don't get school, me involved.
Those when they copy, where we get, you get one book when they call, small book when they call key points. That one, I just like the summary of everything when we say you go need.
Mm-hmm.
Once you just see him, if you sabi buko, because you know easy to copy.
Then you can expand on
you
that one.
You go feel expatiate. Now, this one, you don't talk, just make him look very easy. Say, our Oga president, if just come talk, say, okay, EFCC, Oga, I give you this mandate on the spending of politicians, then go House of Senate. But Oga Duke, if we check out, we know, say, democracy, not be, you know, if you just make certain pronouncements. Somehow, I don't know where they come from, because we get waiting, they go talk, say, okay, you know how they do, and those in favor say aye, those against say nay. Then they will come, they lobby too, because if you can't place yourself against the legislature, like say you won't fight with them, it go there somehow. But if indeed people, when we elect to represent us, they really care about Nigeria, and for the back of their mind, they want to make this country really, really change, then all these things where you don't talk when our Oga president don't fit do, now something when we say all of them go fit go with. But Oga Duke, Nigeria don't reach the level when we say it go hard for you to convince the ordinary Nigerian, say any government, and by any government I mean irrespective of political affiliation, get the interest of Nigerians at heart. Make we look this particular case when get to do with 2.1 billion. I won't come back to this 2.1 billion. This $2.1 billion now, it be like waiting, Nigerians go begin to look as reference, say yes, this government is really serious. But if we don't see as things they go for this country, bail on self-recognition, mm-hmm. next, the person go talk, say, he like saying get headache, he won't travel out for treatment, he won't do this, he won't do that, all those kind of things, they think they cause more problems for this country. Before you go answer that question, because I know say you go need plenty time, as he say, you don't they rub your hand, we go rush, enter inside this break. When we go come back, we'll continue our discussion. Why you they frown? No, tell me, why are you frowning? Why are you frowning? Welcome back to AS E DEY HOT. Ezugwu Chukwudi and Nkubi and our ogbonge visitor for the month of December, Oga Duke Oputa, aka Mr. Equity, the inside studio. And we then discuss the fight against corruption as it ain't get to do with the missing $2.1 billion when we say, some people can't say they want to use buy weapon for our soldier people. But at the end, it can't be like saying a private account, the thing enter. Oga Duke, make I can't drop this one like this now. Now, he get one misconception when they, a lot of people hold them. I never drop them, I never drop them. A lot of people, they hold them, say, if you want take what you know belong to you, take the one with plenty where. Take, for example, if you want take 10 million now, take 25. so that when they catch you,
you can use 15 to.
You go use 15
to fight back.
You go don't keep 10. You go use 15. Settle. If you call it one place, it's go can't go. $2.1 billion Nine be this one we know. You don't think say somehow because some of these people then they come court. The kind of lawyers when they follow their senior advocate, whether they stash. Then they stash their clothes. The thing goes stand like they go enter to come intimidate even the people when they represent the state. How you take reason this particular case? Make we look at.
All right, let me tell you this, yeah. You know, when they fight a big fight like this for a nation, you go try use every means possible. You know, subterfuge, whatever. If you ask me, we have two options. First of all, the most important thing we say, number one, make we stop corruption. That's the most important, stop it. What has happened in the past has happened, but we're not going to leave the thing what happened in the past too, because we want to recover the money where they don't chop, carry, come out from us, yeah? So for me, if you ask me, what I would do is, if I were the president, I would use the law we did there already. And the first law that I would use is a tax law. Because that's the first law I would use. Because first of all, if you have 100 million or 1 billion in your account, and we're having difficulty proving that you stole it, which is the key element. Why bother? Just show us your tax return. Because if you earn the money, you'll have paid tax on it. And if you bring your tax return and it doesn't show that you've earned 1 billion, we'll collect everything from you. Simple. You know, and that is the way to approach it. That's the way I think they would do if not for Budoibo. Yeah, they will use those kind of, because you can't escape that one.
Yes.
You can sit there and argue about whether you stole the money or not, but you can't escape that you didn't pay your tax.
Yes.
So if you didn't pay your tax, that means you didn't earn the money. As far as this government is concerned, if you didn't pay tax on it, you didn't earn it. Because if you earned it, you should have paid tax on it.
Exactly.
And if you avoided the tax, then we can seize the whole money for tax avoidance anyway. So I will use the tax laws to go after the government, rather than just trying to prove that they stole the money. Because at the moment, there are two options for proof when you are looking at situations like that. You can use the option of proof beyond reasonable doubt. That is to show that you've proved beyond reasonable doubt that this event happened. In criminal cases, now that one they use. Because if you're going to hang somebody for a murder, you're going to be sure, say,
beyond all reasonable doubt.
Absolutely.
But go put up. May I just add this one? In a case where our tax law, no, they properly defined, we know this strong.
No, the tax law is defined. The tax law is defined, it's just not being implemented.
But
the
now,
tax,
now
but feel, but that's the whole point. You can pull it up again. You see, you can go bring somebody and say, a tough man, someone like Ribadu, and say, I'm going to make you now the head of Inland Revenue. And your job is to chase every Nigerian with a lot of money and collect the taxes, back taxes they haven't paid. Because if you can collect all the taxes that these guys owe on the money they have, we have probably collected most of the money we need from them.
Exactly.
And then we can then draw a line under everything and say, okay, you cannot go now. We've taken 40% of your 50 billion. It's going to the common. You can now go and carry on your business. We'll not bother you again. And from today, anybody that touches one penny is you know, is 20 years in jail. So there are options of things that can be done to make things happen. But the press, though, has to have the will to go that far. And that is the most important thing.
Oga Duke, as you do like this, based on the powers bestowed on me as the Senate President of AS E DEY HOT, you don't become, you don't, now you be our own minister of...
Wait. Because you look an intelligent man like Oga Oputa finish. You won't be Senate President on top of your head. So, he black no get respect.
He know they here permanently now.
Hey, just at this point in time, that's really talk about. And as long as he there today, he's still a member of the house.
Oga,
and you know, can't they define all this? Hey, Ezugwu, you just respect yourself. And you can't be Senate over me. You can't be Senate President over me. Oga, that's lie. That will not happen.
You take everything like competition.
That will not happen at all.
You see, Oga,
ask your question. Oga, don't you bring in that competition
here. You see, why are you?
Why am I what? Why would you bring race issues when you know, say, myself, I don't go accept that in the first place?
You just some Orubebe-ish behavior about you.
You see what I mean?
Some Orubebe-ish behavior about you.
Chukwudi.
He don't come out cap.
What did you say now?
Matter don't serious.
He remain for that to sit down for grant. We cannot take it, Abi. No, you cannot take it, Abi. You don't see, I'm Oga Duke.
What was that time you just read?
We are discussing progress for Nigeria. I talk say, see the kind of intelligence is what it is. Even the people won't go answer question for front of Senate for the ministerial confirmation. Many of these things that we know as they take commot. See, as they answer the question, they go. And I say, make you become minister. You come there, they talk anything.
You come with or waiting.
I said there is something, as in something, you can't
behave. Spill it out. You have to spill that one out.
I cannot spill it out two times.
Spill it out.
I will not spill it out two times. I will not spill it out. Oga Duke, where your car, you know, concourse, you know, they make network, they shake for here. Oga Duke, we will continue with these questions when will they talk.
Let me ask a question. They take me, they bring me into RAM. Anyway, ask a question. Go ahead.
Oga Duke, we'll continue.
This fight will continue after this program.
No, you know,
it will.
I can see that.
It will. It will.
Make no worry.
Ask your question.
Oga Duke, make we just drop this issue now.
Okay.
From where we did now, we don't discuss this particular matter. No, this is not like the third time when they discuss this missing $2.1 billion. With every time we talk about them, more information they come out. The thing they clear.
Yes.
The first time we first talk about them, we've been reasoning the matter from say, oh, see what thing come out from the issue. The second time we discuss about them now, okay, as they don't arrest some kind of people now, make we continue to they move on. Now when we don't talk and we don't leave the stage where we say, now to the profound solution, now it remain. All the solutions where you don't provide, now things when we say, if we adopt them, it go work. You don't talk about setting benchmarks, say, okay, from the tax system, make we collect some money from people because they get the money, make we collect the percentage back. They can't draw a line to tell people, say, from today, if you carry this kind of leg, now this kind of punishment, now you can see. That one, they're very, very clear. Then number two, you don't state, we need men of integrity. You talk about the Oga of EFCC, say, if Oga Presido, as Commander-in-Chief of the Air Force, tell and say, you have my mandate, you are representing me, and you are representing Nigerians, make sure say you do it this way. Now, if we say nobody go get any excuse,
absolutely,
this one don't carry us to the level where we say, we know, say, some people, they receive phone calls, say, that man, leave him, he's our person, leave him.
Yes.
But if Oga Presido talk, say, everybody is equal,
everybody.
Go after everybody, you don't be very, very clear. Then the third and final one we don't raise, now one of when we say, make Nigerians they very, very hopeful. Because many of us, they think say that only fasting and prayer will we use fight corruption for this country. But you don't make them they very, very clear and very, very simple. Say, now just common sense. And if we carry them as Nigerians talk, say, indeed this corruption won't fight them. All the people when they spread lies for Nigeria say, corruption is part of us. We can only manage it. We cannot take it out of this country. You don't they very, very clear. Oga Duke, if not, we say we still get small time. I thought we will end this program here because this is where you don't talk now. You don't put plenty fire for inside my body. I will go out for street now, begin to preach with all these things when we say you don't raise. If I don't talk again, my mind don't. I've been the first one who started this.
You've said enough. You be orator.
You're right. Now, be the thing. The truth be say, people who they serve us as public servants, we need them to have a mindset which say, as I enter this office for 4 years, I go come out from this office and I'm not going to come out one kobo
exactly
outside my salary.
And it's a possibility.
It's very easy.
Mm-hmm.
It's very easy to do. I mean, I can do it. I mean, I can give you, personally, I would never collect money for anything that I have not worked for. And but that's a personal principle.
Mm-hmm.
I don't expect everybody to have the same principle.
Mm-hmm.
But if I can do it, I'm happy to drive a small car.
Mm-hmm.
I'm happy to live in a small house.
Mm-hmm.
I'm happy to, you know, not to wear a massive, big, expensive clothes. I'm happy to just be happy.
Mm.
I don't know if you know what I mean.
I know.
And at the end of the day, if you have that mindset, then you will not chop any money because most of the guys where they run our government are already rich people.
Exactly.
That's why they're there in the first instance because they've achieved a lot in their own careers.
Mm-hmm.
Some of them have ended up as head of their corporations, so they are well funded financially.
Mm-hmm.
So for instance, for you to go and carry, you know, 2 million naira a month and give to the wife of a minister who is earning already 200 or 300 million a year through his personal
business
legitimate interest, is madness because he doesn't need the 2 million. And these are the small things where we go begin to look to say he no go work anymore.
I'll go put that quickly. May I add this one to him? Mr. President, they represent the executive arm of government.
Yes.
And we can't get the legislative arm of government. We're supposed to work paru pasu.
Mm-hmm.
But in this case, so if we say we need to see that cordial relationship. Young blacks will not see that cordial relationship between these people because what do they find the executive sometimes they for the hand of the legislator? What do also define the legislator somehow they for the hand of the executive? But then in the place where will they see this thing? What do go be the way for? Because young blacks now then they hold all this thing that then they hold them back. Who know if this time achieve?
Okay, that's another thing is if anything any situation come arise where the legislator is being insensitive to the needs of Nigerians, then Nigerians should blockade the Senate. That's the first thing. You should actually get a demonstration and stop the Senate. For me, I would personally lead one. If the Senate is embarked on a cause that is obviously in the interest of their people, but not in our own interest, and it's obvious to us that is the case, I will lead a demonstration. I will say, you're not coming out of this Senate until you change that. And because we are your employers.
Yes.
Now we employ you. Mm-hmm. Now you be our servant. No, be the other way around.
Exactly.
That is another thing, because at the moment, everything in this country is about making governors and legislators like gods. Mm. You know, when a governor they come out for road, you go carry one big, you know, massive convoy. Right. You know, all those things we need to say no. Enough is enough. Yeah. You know, you're a governor, you are a public servant. End of story. You're just simply one notch above the permanent secretary. So why would you run around with 20 cars? For what reason?
Oga Duke, with waiting, you don't talk now. You don't wrap them up. You don't tell us, say, as Nigerians, this country belongs to us.
Of course.
And our hand today, if we want to make this country better. So all of us, when they day very, very passive, say, I don't tire, and I like this, they be. And now time for us to wake up. And now the opportunity when we say, as it hot, they present. Because all of the tori for inside Nigeria politic arrangements, where they come on smoke, we they discuss them here, so that you, self, go there aware, participate for the team, and those where the matter concern go take the necessary action. Oga Duke, we go shake your hand because of, say, even though our invitation come short, you still carry your kind inside our studio.
Thank you very much.
Oga Bobby from Amsterdam, we thank you, we appreciate you. We know say plenty people will try call, but you get the way we network day. Make una continue to watch As E Dey Hot and make una the supporters they go. Nkubi, tell people bye bye now.
You don't tell them. Should we say be senate
president? But my bye bye is my bye bye. Tell
you
your
bye bye. Tell them say be senate president.
Oh, so you don't agree now, Abi?
No, Ugo,
you see that we can walk around the
If you not just enjoy the video they want to just watch, make sure you sharply subscribe to our channel. Not done.